see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
You're supposed to be helping me.
Okay, that's right.
Hey. he's going to tell us to stop. Right.
Here comes the bride. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made the heavens and the earth. You may be seated. I will sing of the Lord's great love forever. With my mouth, I will make your faithfulness known to all generations. I will declare your love stands firm forever, that you established your faithfulness in heaven itself. Grace and peace be with us all. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. We are gathered here to praise God for the covenant of grace and reconciliation made with us through Christ Jesus, to hear it proclaimed anew and to respond to it as we witness the covenant of marriage, Steve and Kristen make with each other in Christ's name. Christian marriage is a joyful covenanting between a man and a woman in which they proclaim before God and human witnesses their commitment to live together in spiritual, physical, and material unity. In this covenant, they acknowledge that the great love God has shown for each of us enables them to love each other. They affirm that God's gracious presence and abiding power are needed for them to keep their vows, to continue to live in love, and to be faithful servants of Christ in this world. For human commitment is fragile and human love is imperfect, but the promise of God is eternal, and the love of God can bring our love to perfection. And now more than ever, we cling to this incredible promise of Christ's love for us. Few are gathered in this space, but we trust there are many others that are watching in on their devices, here, there, and everywhere. And we also want to pause and remember that there are other loved ones who are not watching this side of God's glory, but are in the presence of our Heavenly Father already. And we certainly acknowledge their presence here in spirit, both Kristen's father, Bob, and Steve's father, George. Their presence is certainly felt and remembered by each one of us. They are loved and missed. Will you join me in prayer this afternoon? Most gracious God, be with us in this time of joy and celebration. Reveal the good news of your love for us in the proclamation of your word. Enable us to respond to you with faithfulness and obedience, so that in all we do and say, your name may be praised. Through Jesus Christ our Lord we pray. Amen and amen. Well, this time we have our scripture readings, and I think this is so cool, but each of these beautiful young men and young women have some words of instruction for their parents to pass along, straight from God's word. And so Allie and Ashlyn are going to read the first reading from 1 Corinthians.
1 Corinthians 13, 4 through 5. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud.
It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs.
Amen. Great words of wisdom to share with your parents. And next we have Stephen, and he is going to read from Proverbs chapter 30. One that I, even a professional at this, still don't understand either.
Proverbs 30, 18 to 19. There are three things that amaze me. No, four things that I don't understand. How an eagle glides through the sky. How a snake slithers on a rock. How a ship navigates the ocean. How a man loves a woman.
Man, thank you, Stephen. And Michael is going to share with us a reading from 1 John.
Good job, dude.
1 John 4:16, and so we know and rely on the love God has for us. God is love. Whoever lives in love lives in God, and God in them.
Amen. Thank you, Michael. And thank each one of you for those beautiful words of encouragement for all of us today, and especially for you, Kristen, and for you, Steve. Well, there's a rule in spelling that I'm sure we all remember. It goes something like this. I before E, except after C. Well, scholars have recently got together, as scholars tend to do, and they've decided that that I before E rule was no longer acceptable. In other words, it was a bad rule. Too often it could be misunderstood and proved wrong. So, see what I did there? Proverbial slip, right? So the scholars, I guess, are hoping to rid us of this rule. We'll see if the I's have it or not. Our passage this afternoon, the first one that we heard, gives us another rule. It's thankfully not a grammar rule, but rather a love rule. And it's the one rule that I want to leave with both you, Kristen, and you, Steve, on this your wedding day. Are you ready for the rule? Here it is. It is you always comes before I. Let me say it one more time. You comes before I. Paul in 1 Corinthians is introducing us to a new reality in Christ. And that is this: Christian love is never self-seeking. It is always self-giving. Again, there's our rule. You comes before I. I'm confident of two things this day. The first is this, Steve: a happy wife makes a happy life. And one far more important thing, this you before I love is the same love that we see in Christ Jesus, who is himself love incarnate. There's another grammar rule for us today, and that is our language is far too simplistic. The language in which these words of Scripture from 1 Corinthians were originally written in had four different words for our singular word love. They knew that loving a favorite food like barbecue that you guys had last night or a TV show was different from loving a husband or wife. This love which Paul speaks of is agape love. And again, simply put, means you before I love. It's the love we see in Jesus above all else. I never thought when Kristen first reached out to me to plan this beautiful day in June, the first Saturday in June, that these would be the days and times we are living in. And I know I am preaching to the choir when I say that every single one here present and listening in has seen everything change before our eyes and our hearts be broken in recent days in particular. I never knew that our first pre-marriage counseling session in person would be our last in person as we quickly shifted to Zoom meetings over these last few months. But in those times, we did a lot of good work together, had a lot of great conversations. You learned about loving each other in a way that honors God and blesses one another above all else. Kristen, you learned that quality time is the way you give and receive love best. And Steve, you learned that physical touch is the way you give and receive love best. And I can't encourage you once again, as I have been throughout our whole journey, to continue practicing this you before I love as you grow in understanding these love languages for yourself and for one another. Steve and Kristen, it is so apparent in your life together that you share this kind of love for one another. As you become husband and wife on this day, it is my great prayer, it is my great hope that this will be a mark of your continued journey of practicing and perfecting this love rule in Christ Jesus for his glory and for the good of one another. The good news today is this, Steve. For God so loves you that as you believe in him, you'll be able to love Kristen as much as you do today, forever and ever. And the good news today is this, Kristen. For God so loves you that as you believe in him, you'll be able to love Steve as much as you do today, forever and forever. Thanks be to God. Amen and amen. Will you join me in prayer? Almighty God, through your grace, write all these words on our hearts. May they bring forth in each one of us the fruit of the Spirit to honor and praise your name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen and amen. Well, we move now to the moment in our service entitled the Declaration of Consent. And we practiced this a couple times, so you guys should be good to go, right?
Absolutely.
Stephen, we will begin with you. I will say these sentences, and then you respond with, I will with the help of God. Stephen, will you receive Kristen as your wife? Bind yourself to her in the covenant of marriage. Will you promise to love and honor her in true devotion, to rejoice with her in times of felicity and grieve with her in times of sorrow, and be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will with the help of God.
Amen. And Kristen, you too will respond, I will with the help of God. Kristen, will you receive Stephen as your husband and bind yourself to him in the covenant of marriage? Will you promise to love and honor him in true devotion, to rejoice with him in times of felicity and grieve with him in times of sorrow, and be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will with the help of God.
Amen. And now we'd like all here present, both in person and if you are watching in through other channels, feel free to respond, and we will trust the Spirit will move in such a way that we can feel your presence all these miles away. Will you, the beloved family and friends of Kristen and Stephen, receive them into your family, uphold them with your love as they establish themselves as a family within your own? Amen and amen. At this time, Stephen and Kristen, I invite you before God and all here present to share your vows with one another. Steve, will you repeat after me? I, Steve. Take you, Kristen. To be my wife. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. As long as we both shall live. To this I pledge myself. Truly.
Truly.
With all my heart. And Steve, what symbol of your love and covenant and marriage do you have to give to Kristen this day?
This ring.
Repeat after me. This ring I give. In token of the covenant. Made this day.
Between us.
In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And Kristen, will you repeat after me these vows that you are making before God and all here present of your love and devotion for Steve? I, Kristen. Take you, Steve. To be my husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better, for worse.
For better or worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live. To this I pledge myself. Truly.
Truly.
With all my heart. And Kristen, what symbol do you have of your love and covenant of marriage to Stephen this day?
This ring.
Repeat after me. This ring I give.
In token of the covenant.
Made this day.
Between us.
In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. As a symbol of their love for one another and the joining of their lives and their families into one, Kristen and Steve will at this time light their unity candle.
I think it's coming up.
I love these words from Matthew chapter 5 as an awesome reminder of Christ's love for us and what he calls us to as his followers. As you are bearing witness for us this day, as a family yoked in the love of Jesus Christ, Jesus tells us this: you are the salt of the earth, but if salt has lost its taste, how shall its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled under feet. You are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden, nor do people light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a stand, and it gives light to the entire house. In the same way, let your light shine before others so they may see your good works and always give glory to your Father who is in heaven. Amen and amen. Yes. Friends, will you join me in prayer? God, you are the creator of life. You are the author of salvation. You are the giver of all good gifts. Look with favor upon Kristen and Stephen and their beloved family this day as they have covenanted marriage in your name. Bless their union and sustain them in their devotion to each other and to you. Grant them the desire to order their lives according to your will, that in their relationship with each other and with those around them, they will show forth the joy and peace of Christ. Sustain them in seasons and conditions of their lives by the power of your Holy Spirit, that in joy and sorrow, leisure and labor, plenty and want, they may give thanks for your steadfast love and declare your faithfulness before the world. Increase in them the will to grow in faith and service to Christ. Let their life together bear witness to the healing and reconciling love of Christ for this troubled and broken world. Give them a deep appreciation of the unity of all persons within your creation, that their love for each other may be reflected also in their desire for justice, dignity, and meaning for your children. Keep ever vivid in their hearts a vision of your kingdom and enable them to live in the hope of its fulfillment. By the power of your Spirit, accomplish these things, we pray, in accordance with your will. In your name we pray, Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
And amen. Amen. Beloved in the Lord, Stephen and Kristen have made their covenant of marriage together before God and all here present by solemn vows, by the joining of hands, and the giving and receiving of rings. Therefore, I declare that they are husband and wife. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, be united, live in peace, and the God of peace be with you always. They are no longer two, but one. What God has united, let no one separate. Steve, you may now kiss your bride.
Love you.
Friends, it is my great joy and honor to announce for the first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Long.
Thank you. Pittsburgh, where's it?
Pictures.
How do you get dressed so quick, all you guys?
We are quick.
We're just back.